So guys, before we dive into the three productivity apps to get in 2019, I want to thank Skillshare for sponsoring today's video. For those who don't know, Skillshare is an online learning platform with thousands of classes ranging from design, business, technology, and so much more. I've been a big fan of using and teaching on their platform for a while. Now, Skillshare has a premium membership giving you access to unlimited classes to help you to improve your skills in so many different areas, whether that's crafting or animating, or even creating new concepts, or even getting started as a freelancer. And the great thing is it's affordable. With their annual plan, you can get it for less than $10 a month. So guys, the first 500 people will get 2 months free trial to Skillshare Premium, meaning you can get access to all the classes, including mine, and a recently released student course too. Very exciting. Anyway guys, let's dive into today's video. So what applications in 2019 do you need to look out for? Now, in today's video, I'm going to be diving into three apps that I think you should 100% check out in 2019 as something that you should definitely consider in your process. So let's dive into today's video. So guys, the first application, if you follow this channel, probably won't come a surprise to you. It is Notion. Now, Notion in 2019 has an exciting journey potentially if they release an API to make and connect with other applications. It's going to be an exciting year for them. Now, for those who don't know, Notion is an application that allows you to build your own productivity software. And that's amazing because you can craft essentially any tool or any workspace that you like to get your work done. Whether that's for planning, whether that's for tracking, whether that's for building your own CRM, whatever it is, Notion has a website builder layout that allows you just to build your own applications. Now in 2019, I think Notion definitely has an opportunity of being the most successful application. And it could potentially rival applications like Evernote, Trello, Todoist, and many more if it continues down its road of being an all-round application. So my recommendation is if you're definitely looking at something like this for 2019, then definitely check out Notion. It's available on pretty much all applications and it's something you should definitely try out. My number two is Habitify. And the reason why I want to share with you about Habitify is after reading Atomic Habits by James Clear. I think this is a smashing book. I read it on Audible. I listened to it on Audible and found it really useful. And it really encouraged the act of actually doing positive habits. And I think habit tracking applications, some are great, some are really lacking in it. Habitify, although available only on iOS and Mac right now, is one of those apps that does look exciting in 2019. Now they're planning to release an Android application, and it's something that if you were able to get started with in terms of starting a habit tracking process, whether you're a student, whether you're a professional, or whether you're just using it for casual use, it's something that I think is definitely going to be something you're going to use in 2019. And number three, an exciting application that I was really shocked by because I looked at it and then returned to it this year, is TaskAid. Now TaskAid, I did a full first impressions feature if you want to check it out below. It's a to-do list slash list building application. So essentially, you can build up lists, meeting notes, you can even build a bullet journal in it if you want. It's very similar, it's sort of like a blend between Notion, which we explained in the first, and Todoist, which is a popular task manager. So the application is growing pretty rapidly. It's available on pretty much every platform, but the exciting thing is it's free and you can invite unlimited collaborators. So if you're looking to get a basic task manager slash list builder and you want to be able to use it in a team, you can download it for free, collaborate for free, and even invite guests to the different boards or areas that you use. So it's quite an exciting application in that manner, and I definitely see it doing well in 2019. So guys, let me know in the comments what three apps you think will be doing well in 2019. Those are my three. I think they're definitely warrant a head nod at least. So definitely go away and download them in the description below if you're interested in checking them out. Anyway guys, a huge thank you for stopping by today. Make sure to subscribe if you're brand new to Keep Productive, and I will see you all in a future video. Cheers.